Let's talk about walk-ins and let's just get right into it, okay? If you're watching the video, it's because you saw a walk-in and you go, well, let me know about walk-ins. Well, here's what about walk-ins. Quick and dirty, okay? If you are a walk-in, your shit can get ragged and you're going to feel like all this stuff. Which one is it? Where is it? Oh, yeah, number 6. Oh, you ever feel like that? Shit? Ever? What that is the old you, the previous occupant, wants out, and they get stuck. One weird reason or another, either they're afraid to leave, or they want to go, but they're being held on to by either you, unconsciously, you, the new guy, new gal, accidentally, sorry, or the body's hanging on to them, or some creepy thing happened when you were walking in, an entity latched onto you before you even got in. It's called a shove in. Yeah. Okay. Creepy. And then you walk in after it shoves into your space and consciousness. You walk into the body and now you're corrupt, like a Trojan horse thing is in you. And now when you try to do what you walked in to do, you can't do it because there's this massive confusion in there because of this entity that got into your space. And so there's a fix. We can fix all this stuff. Absolutely. So I wanted to share this with you. So this walk-in checklist. I've done this before, but wow, it can be a thing. And if you were a walk-in, but you sort of sorted it out, but things are getting raggedy again, you might want to consider, is there another walk-in? Are you the next in line of walk-in after walk-in? Yeah, that's the thing, okay? All right, so are you on a spiritual path or a working journey? Well, yes, I am, Rich. Thanks for asking. Do you sense many odd things in your life but can't seem to think about them? Yeah, there's things that I want to do or think about or focus on, and there's just this there's something deep within going, yeah, no, not going there. Yeah. So, I have incomplete memories of childhood. Yeah. It's like walk-ins will have like keyframes, moments sprinkled through the entire life. So when you take a quick glance, I remember my childhood. Yeah. I remember last year. I remember 2 years ago. I remember 5 years ago, 10 years. Yeah. No, you don't. Not necessarily. You might, but nah. What happens, you remember keyframes, and that's the point. You got keyframes that gives you the idea that you can remember your past. But when you try to look into the in-between places, it's kind of like, huh, what? But if you work it really hard, you can tap into those memories because your body has the memory of the entire life. You know, the walk out, or that's supposed to walk out, they have a memory of the entire life. And when you come in, you take on their memories, but you know, you don't want to take on all their baggage and all their issues and all that stuff. That's the whole point. You don't want to be them. They don't want to be you. They went out of here. You went in here for whatever reason, and here you are. You don't want to take on their shit. So you don't. Including, you don't take on all their memory stuff. Okay. But the body lived through all of it, and it remembers too. But you can make friends with your body, and you know, everything will be fine. But if you're in a clusterfuck of having walked in, and the previous occupant perhaps maybe didn't walk out, or they walked out and they left their baggage, their mental and emotional traumas and issues, and you accidentally appropriated or assumed those issues as your own. And those can be hard to shake too, because we're not used to being walk-ins if we're walk-ins. It doesn't necessarily mean we're old hands at being a walk-in. No, it might be new stuff for you, but you wanted to give it a go for whatever reason, as a star seed, as a wonderful being here to do what you're supposed to do or want to do or choose to do. And there's a gazillion different reasons why people will walk in. But now that you're here, the trick is to, one, if it went sideways, you want to clean it up. Okay. And so now you can get a, you know, a better perspective on who and what you're all about. Okay. So you want to help the previous walk-in or the previous occupant get away clean. And if there's another entity involved that's mucking up the works, you want to address that and get rid of him. And this is all doable. I've done it plenty of times. It's totally doable, and it's so refreshing. And that number six symptom just goes away because the guy got away. The guy or the gal did get away. They want to leave. They want out of here. Whatever it takes. That's not you if you're the new walk-in. That's the other guy. Look, we had a deal here. I was only have to spend so many years here, and I'm out of here. What's happening? Why am I still here? I want out of here. Right? Like that. Yeah, yeah. So we can help them get away. And usually a walk-in, walk-out process, even if it goes smoothly, you get a little bit of that funny feeling stuff. And it can take a few days to a few weeks, maybe even longer sometimes, the process of handing over the hat or changing the guard, so to speak. So there's a lot of things involved. But if it's you and you want some clearing on this stuff, give me a jingle. Actually, you can go over to my website, get a free consultation about your walk-in possibility, maybe, I don't know, Rich, kind of thing. Leave your number. I'll give you a jingle. Hey, son. And we'll talk about it a little bit. And then if you think, you want a session, great. But I will turn you on to some techniques that are free if you want to go at it on your own. Yeah, that's doable too. They're not free techniques. I'm sorry. There's an ebook by Jaden Fox, jaden-fox.com, I think. He's got a walk-in section. And this is where I learned the technique. And I bought his ebook for $25 or something like that. Okay. Because I've done a lot of work over the years, spiritual work, entity work, clearing of different kinds, it was easy for me to understand the phenomena and the techniques, and I was able to pick up the skill set required to help myself and others deal with this walk-in issue thingy. Okay, so it's such a wonderful relief when you spot with certainty that you are walking, when you walked in, why you walked in, did the other guy leave, and when did he leave, and how do you get him to leave, and all that. It's such a turnaround for you, and it can relieve a lot of stress and uncomfortable, confusing things if it's happened to you. So I wanted to just give you a heads up. If that's you, or you think it might be you, leave your phone number, I'll give you a call. We'll talk about it, and then if you'd like to book a session with me, great. If not, hey, we got to talk. You know, if you are a walk-in, chances are we know each other from, yeah, quite possible. Yeah, I'm just saying, I've been meeting a lot of wonderful people over the phone that have been taking me up on my free consultation offer. It's great. So, don't be a stranger, all right? I'll call you. You leave your number. When I get a chance, I just call you. There's no appointment or anything. It's like, sometimes I can call like in 5 minutes after you leave your number. Sometimes it takes a couple of days, but yeah, yeah. All righty? Okay. Looking forward to meeting you and you and you and the other you and the other you too. We'll all be friends. We'll work it out together. All righty? Okay. Now get out of here.